Good day, everyone. In this video, we will discuss about limits of algebraic functions. Theorem number 8, limit of a polynomial function. For a polynomial function f in terms of x, the limit of f of x as x approaches c is equal to f of c, where c is any real number. Therefore, to determine the limit of a polynomial function, we simply need to substitute c to our f of x. Now, let us take some examples to apply theorem number 8. Evaluate the following limits. For the first example, we have the limit of 2x minus 7 as x approaches 1/2. Using theorem number 8, remember that we simply need to substitute 1/2 to x. Therefore, we're gonna have 2 times 1/2 minus 7. Evaluate 2 times 1/2, we will have 1 minus 7. Simplifying 1 minus 7, we will have negative 6. Therefore, the limit of 2x minus 7 as x approaches 1/2 is equal to negative 6. Let us try another one. Limit of x cubed plus x squared minus 5x plus 1 as x approaches negative 2. Again, to apply theorem number 8, we simply need to substitute negative 2 to the variable x on our polynomial function. Hence, we will have negative 2 cubed plus negative 2 squared minus 5 times negative 2 plus 1. Now simplify negative 2 cubed, negative 2 squared, and negative 5 times negative 2. Hence, we will have negative 8 plus 4 plus 10 plus 1. Simplifying this expression, we will arrive at the final answer 7. Therefore, the limit of x cubed plus x squared minus 5x plus 1 as x approaches negative 2 is 7. Theorem number 9, limit of a rational function. For a rational function f in terms of x, the limit of f of x as x approaches c will be equal to the limit of p of x over q of x as x approaches c, which will be equal to p of c divided by q of c, wherein c is any real number x and q of c cannot be equal to 0. Because remember, when the denominator becomes 0, then the entire expression becomes undefined. Hence, what we simply need to do to determine the limit of a rational function is to substitute c to our numerator and to our denominator. Now, let us take this example to apply theorem number 9. Evaluate the following limits. Limit of x divided by x plus 6 as x approaches 5. Using theorem number 9, we simply need to substitute 5 to the variable x. So we will have 5 over 5 plus 6. Simplifying this expression, then we will have 5 over 11. Therefore, the limit of x over x plus 6 as x approaches 5 is equal to 5 over 11. Let us take another example. Limit of x squared plus 2x plus 4 all over 3x squared minus x plus 8 as x approaches 1. Again, we simply need to substitute 1 to the variable x on our rational function. So we're gonna have 1 squared plus 2 times 1 plus 4 all over 3 times 1 squared minus 1 plus 8. Simplifying 1 squared, 2 times 1, 3 times 1 squared, we will have 1 plus 2 plus 4 all over 3 minus 1 plus 8. Simplifying the numerator and the denominator, we will have the final answer 7 over 10. Thus, the limit of x squared plus 2x plus 4 all over 3x squared minus x plus 8 as x approaches 1 is equal to 7 over 10. Remember that in case that when the evaluation of f of c leads to an indeterminate or 0 over 0, which occurs when number c is a 0 of both the numerator and denominator, simplify first the rational function by canceling the common factor or factors of the numerator and denominator. The resulting simplified form of the rational function will be used in evaluating the limit of the given function. With this, let us take another example. The limit of x plus 3 over x squared minus 9 as x approaches negative 3. Notice that when we substitute negative 3 at the numerator and negative 3 at the denominator, we will arrive at negative 3 plus 3 all over negative 3 squared minus 9. When we will evaluate this, we will have 0 over 0, which is an indeterminate. If this would be the case, we need to observe our rational function if we can still simplify it. Simplify it by canceling a common factor. Now notice that we can actually factor the denominator x squared minus 9 into x plus 3 times x minus 3. And with that, we can actually cancel the common factor x plus 3 at the numerator and at the denominator, leaving us with the limit of 1 over x minus 3. From here, we can now apply the theorem number 9, wherein we need to substitute negative 3 on the variable x on our given function. Thus, we will have 1 over negative 3 minus 3, which will be equal to negative 6. Thus, the limit of x plus 3 over x squared minus 9 as x approaches negative 3 is equal to negative 1 over 6. Let us try another one. Limit of x squared plus 20x all over x squared plus 21x plus 20 as x approaches negative 20. Again, notice that when we substitute negative 20 on our function all over negative 20 squared plus 21 times negative 20 plus 20, we will have another indeterminate 0 over 0. And with this, it only means that we need to simplify first our rational function by canceling out common factors at the numerator and at the denominator. Now notice that the numerator x squared plus 20x can be factored as x times x plus 20, while the denominator can be factored as x plus 1 times x plus 20. So here, the common factor is x plus 20. Canceling x plus 20, our rational function will be simplified into x over x plus 1. In evaluating the limit of x over x plus 1 as x approaches negative 20, we need to substitute negative 20 on our variable x. So we will have negative 20 all over negative 20 plus 1, which will be equal to 20 over 19. Therefore, the limit of x squared plus 20x all over x squared plus 21x plus 20 as x approaches negative 20 is 20 over 19. For some cases, some rational expressions needed other algebraic manipulations when simplifying other than factoring and canceling. For an instance, evaluate the following limits. limit of 1 over x minus 1/3 all over x minus 3 as x approaches 3. Notice that when we substitute 3 on the variable x here, we will be having an indeterminate 0, 0. However, we cannot factor the numerator and the denominator. Therefore, there is no common factor that we can cancel out. With this, what we need to do is apply some algebraic manipulations like subtracting the numerator. When we do that, 1 over x minus 1/3 will be equal to 3 minus x over 3x. Remember that when we divide fractions, we get the reciprocal of the denominator and multiply it to our numerator. So therefore, we have 3 minus x all over 3x times 1 all over x minus 3. Notice that these two binomials here can be the same when we factor out negative 1 from one of them. Suppose we will be factoring out negative 1 from this rational expression, then we will have negative 1 all over 3 minus x. With this, we can now cancel this common factor, leaving us with the limit of negative 1 over 3x as x approaches 3. From here, we can now substitute 3 to the variable x. That would be equal to negative 1 all over 3 times 3, which will be equal to negative 1 over 9. Therefore, the limit of 1 over x minus 1/3 all over x minus 3 as x approaches 3 is equal to negative 1 over 9. Notice that on the process, we did not only use canceling common factors, but we did some algebraic manipulations like subtracting fractions. Let us consider another one. Limit of the square root of x plus 6 minus square root of 6 all over x as x approaches 0. For this case, notice that when we substitute 0 on our x here, we will have square root of 0 plus 6 minus square root of 6 all over 0, which we will have 0 plus 6 will be square root of 6 minus square root of 6 over 0, which will be equal to 0 over 0, which is an indeterminate. It only implies that we need some algebraic manipulations on this expression. Hence, to do that, we will be multiplying both the numerator and the denominator by the conjugate of the numerator. Remember that the conjugate expression is the opposite operation of the given expression. So therefore, we will be multiplying both the numerator and the denominator by square root of x plus 6 plus square root of 6 all over square root of x plus 6 plus square root of 6. With that, our expression will become square root of x plus 6 quantity squared minus square root of 6 quantity squared all over x quantity square root of x plus 6 plus square root of 6. Simplifying the numerator, we will have x plus 6 minus 6 all over the same denominator. Notice that on the numerator, 6 minus 6, it will become simply x. From here, we can now see a common factor on the numerator and the denominator, which is the x. So canceling x, we will have 1 all over square root of x plus 6 plus square root of 6. From here, you can now substitute 0 on the variable x, giving us with 1 over square root of 0 plus 6 plus square root of 6. Simplifying it, we will have 1 over square root of 6 plus square root of 6, which will be equal to 1 over 2 square root of 6. Rationalizing it, we will have square root of 6 over 12. Thus, the limit of the given function is square root of 6 over 12. Theorem number 10, limit of a radical function. For a radical function f in terms of x, the limit of f of x as x approaches c is equal to the limit of nth root of p of x as x approaches c, which is equal to the nth root of the limit of p of x as x approaches c, where c is any real number, n is a positive integer n, and p of c should be greater than 0 if n is even. So therefore, if we have a radical function and we want to find its limit, remember that it will be equal to the nth root of the limit of p of x as x approaches c. Now, we take some examples in applying theorem number 10. Evaluate the following limits. Limit of square root of 9 minus x squared as x approaches 1. Applying theorem number 10, the limit of the square root of 9 minus x squared as x approaches 1 is equal to the square root of the limit of 9 minus x squared as x approaches 1. From here, we simply need to substitute 1 on our variable x. So we will have a square root of 9 minus 1 squared. Simplifying it, we will have a square root of 8, which is equal to 2 square root of 2. Therefore, the limit of square root of 9 minus x squared as x approaches 1 is equal to 2 square root of 2. Another example, limit of the square root of x squared plus x plus 5 all over 3x plus 7 as x approaches negative 2. Applying theorem number 10, since we have a square root or radical expression at the numerator, then it will be equal to the square root of the limit of x squared plus x plus 5 as x approaches negative 2 all over the limit of 3x plus 7 as x approaches negative 2. From here, substitute negative 2 to the variable x both in the numerator and at the denominator, giving us with square root of negative 2 squared plus 1 times negative 2 plus 5 all over 3 times negative 2 plus 7. Simplifying it, we will have a square root of 4 minus 2 plus 5 all over negative 6 plus 7. Hence, we will have square root of 7. Limits of piecewise functions. Given the piecewise function f of x, which is equal to 1 plus x if x is less than or equal to negative 2, 2 minus x if x is greater than negative 2 but less than or equal to 2, and 2x minus 1 if x is greater than 2. Find the limit of the piecewise function f of x as x approaches negative 5. Since x approaches negative 5, negative 5 is in the interval x is less than or equal to negative 2. Thus, we will use the function f of x is equal to 1 plus x. Therefore, the limit of f of x as x approaches negative 5 will be equal to the limit of 1 plus x as x approaches negative 5. Now, let us apply theorem number 8, which is the limit of the polynomial function. Applying it, we need to substitute negative 5 to the variable x, giving us with 1 minus 5, which will be equal to negative 4. Therefore, the limit of f of x as x approaches negative 5 is equal to negative 4. Another example, using the same piecewise function, let us determine the limit of f of x as x approaches 0. Since x approaches 0 and it is in the interval x is greater than negative 2 but less than or equal to 2, we will use the function 2 minus x. Hence, the limit of f of x as x approaches 0 will be equal to the limit of 2 minus x as x approaches 0. From here, substitute 0 on the variable x, we will have 2 minus 0, which will be equal to 2. Hence, the limit of f of x as x approaches 0 is equal to 2. Let us try another one. The limit of f of x as x approaches 3. Since x approaches 3 and 3 is in the interval x greater than 2, then we will use the function 2x minus 1. Therefore, the limit of f of x as x approaches 3 will be equal to the limit of 2x minus 1 as x approaches 3. Substituting 3 to the variable x, we will have 2 times 3 minus 1, which will be equal to 5. Thus, the limit of f of x as x approaches 3 is equal to 5. I hope that you have understood the lesson. For our next video, we will discuss about one-sided limits and infinite limits. Thank you so much for listening and see you on our next discussion. Thank you.